And welcome to part two. Let's play Banjo-Kazooie. I apparently don't have time for my own fucking intro. So, yes, we're going to the first world now, Mumbo's Mountain, where we get introduced to probably one of my favorite characters in the entire franchise. Actually, all of Rare, for that matter. But we'll get to that when we see him.
Hey, Gumbo, Gumbo.
All of these constant interruptions during commentary are going to get a little annoying. However, it's just for like... that's going to happen. Now, in every world, you will have 5 Jinjos to collect, as they told us, Mumbo tokens to collect, to talk to the Great Shaman himself, notes to collect to unlock note doors, Jiggies to collect to open new worlds. Oh boy. Welcome to the era of the Super Mario 64. Honeycombs are health. In order to replenish honeycombs, you must kill enemies or find beehives. Beehives hold 3, enemies hold 1. Now let's get to our first Jiggy, shall we? Pretty obvious, all you gotta do is have him throw the oranges on the switches.
Ha ha ha!
And yes, Kazooie does lay eggs out of her ass. Okay, we got the joke over. I swear to God, I've gotten to dodge those by just doing back. Like all three of them, one after another, after another, after another, but I've never been able to do it again. I swear I've done it. So yeah, three eggs and he goes down, nothing big. Oh, screw you, Bottles. Yes, we will be getting the Talon Trot later, one of the few moves that I actually remember the name to. Now, for those of you going, oh my god, you suck at this game, you're getting hit level 1. I'm just playing the game for fun. If I wanted to show off skill, I'd be showing off skill. But hey, look, another jiggy. Boing! Awesome. There's a Mumbo token behind this pillar right here. And yes, I do pretty much have this entire game memorized. I can 99% this game easy. Now for those of you wondering, wait a minute, only 99? Yes, only 99. Both Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Kazooie, I can only get 99% on. I cannot, for the life of me, get one jiggy in Banjo-Kazooie. Yes, it is the one you're thinking of in Rusty Bucket Bay. I will be avoiding that one. And the one that I can't get in Banjo-Tooie is in Cloud Cuckoo Land. I'm really good at these games. I just can't get those two. And I hate this honeycomb piece. I always have trouble with it because it's impossible to aim while going down. But whatever. Oh yeah, something I should mention. The bull here, to my knowledge, is invincible. You get no honeycombs from him, you can only temporarily stun him as I did earlier in the video. There we go. Oh yeah, in each world, I forgot to mention this, has two honeycomb pieces. You collect 6 honeycomb pieces as you did in the tutorial stage. And you get a new honeycomb piece. Just think of them as heart pieces and heart containers from Zelda. Okay, one more and I got half the notes. Uh-huh. Yes, this world is extremely simple. You don't even need a guide for this part of the game. For me, the game really doesn't get hard until, Clinker's Cavern and, oh my god, I'm an idiot. Okay, looks like we're coming back. Oh, yeah, as long as you don't have, the ground pound move, you can jump off those guys. It's actually kind of entertaining. But now we have the big breaker, which is a completely broken move. It's exactly the same as Mario's ground pound, and it's just as abusable. And wow, you might actually get to hear me talk for a full fucking minute in this one. I know, weird, right? But anyway, yeah, I would not suggest opening that one, and actually what's in these is given away in one of the beginning movie demo things. Hey, look, it's the green Jinjo. Now we're only missing one. Another Banjo trophy, which gives us an extra life. Jiggy hidden inside the thing, of course. I think the Jinjo and the Jiggy are interchangeable. I could be wrong about that. Because I know the Jiggy is not always in the last one you break. I think it's either interchangeable with the Jinjo, so it appears that way, or, it actually is always in that one, and that's always the last one I break. There's the yellow Jinjo. Collect all 5 Jinjos, get a Jiggy. You know, I really want to know what Rare was on when they made this game. Because a bear, a chicken, creatures called Jinjos, musical notes, Jiggies, a witch, a mole that gives you moves. This game is like 7 different flavors of crazy. And I love it so much. This is what the inside of my mind is like, except a little bit darker. Alright, now that we have the beak break move, we can go hit that witch switch. Now you may be asking, which switch? This switch. This witch switch right here. Try saying that 5 times fast. This witch switch right here. Alright, I think we have enough tokens to go see Mumbo, but before I do anything, I want to make sure that I can get out of this world. Oh no, I'm going to see Mumbo, my bad. Go up, come up, Ah, yes, Mumbo. Not as good as Wumbo, but we'll get to that when we get to it. Need one more Mumbo token. I have a vague recollection of it being up here, but that might be a different hut. Ow! Okay, seriously? Three places in the entire hut that I can hit to injure myself, and I managed to hit one. Lame. Ha, alright. So... yeah. This is kind of a dick move on the designer parts. It's not bad. See, this room you have to be a termite to actually access fully. But you need to come in here to get the last Mumbo token you need. A little annoying, guys. Just a tad. But yes, this transformation is termite. Now, all the transformations have their pros and cons, usually the cons being you can't attack. Thus why Wumbo is the superior shaman, because all of her forms can use some form of offensive capability. The termite allows you to climb on practically vertical surfaces. Now, you can't climb up walls per se, but... not even Kazooie's talent trot could successfully climb all of this. And yeah, the camera angle's a little wonky, so if you're playing along with me, you will fall a few times. I think I've managed to do this once without falling. But at least I don't always fall to the very bottom. Now, the termites will leave you alone as, well, actually they leave you alone as either Banjo or the termite, but, they'll actually talk to you as the termite, ask you where you got your shorts and whatnot. I think we've seen at least one example of that. But they only have two interchangeable lines, which are, where'd you get the backpack, and where did you get the shorts? Another Banjo trophy up here, if you're interested. And the last Jiggy of this world is, of course, on top of the Termite Mountain. And there is this. You can walk underwater as a termite for as long as you want. I'm pretty sure that was a flaw on the designer's part. Or an error on the designer's part. And that's how you get that Jiggy. And as you saw there, Mumbo's magic has its limits. Yes, it's Verizon magic. I stole Nintendo Capri Sun's joke. Oh my god. Anyway, it has its limits, and every time you go into a world, enemies will come out. But before we do anything else, let's go grab this honeycomb piece we missed. To get it, you essentially knock everyone but one away. By the way, physics don't work like that. And that's how you do that. Alright, I think that's about everything we need to do at the moment. Anything else will be done in the next episode, or at least in the next arc. Where will we be doing worlds 2 and 3? Why 2 and 3? Because their puzzles are right next to each other. But yeah, I think that's everything. So, just some quick trivia about this palace. If you look around on the walls, you can see various incarnations of, well, various drawings of things. The obvious two being the pumpkin head and the demon's mask. But I think you can see every one of your transformations that Mumbo gives you. 18 minutes? Wow, that was fast. We'll get to the stop and swap stuff when we get to it, but I think we're quitting. Trivia! That game over screen used to give me nightmares. Okay, I lied. There's one thing that I forgot. There's this little bit of dialogue in between Bottles, Banjo, and Kazooie that nobody ever shows off. By the way, every time you reset the game, you lose all the lives you've collected. Yeah, that's kind of a dick move, isn't it? Still looks like I'll be playing most of this game on 3 lives. Oh, joy. But yeah. You can revisit Banjo's house at any point. By the way, I hope you like the Talentrot sound, because you're going to be hearing it a lot. Come on, just a little closer. No, too close. But as you can see, you can pretty much see everything. And we will be exploring more of that and this game next time. Later.